Hi friends, let us learn the backpropagation algorithm, which is very important and mostly used algorithm in neural network. And this algorithm is generally used in multi-layer neural networks. And let us see first what is this algorithm. This is a simple signal flow graph of one neuron has been taken here. The neuron is jth neuron. Of course, here there are some input neurons y0, y1 and so on up to yi and yi plus 1 and so on up to ym, where n indicates the nth iteration that gives you the time. And coming to wji of n, we already discussed how to represent the synaptic weights, as the synaptic weight is connected from yi to vj. So we can say that this is wji. That means first output node has to be represented, or output neuron has to be represented. So wji of n, and from starting, that is the bias. So wj0 of n is equal to bj of n. So that is the bias point. So the input is 1, or the activation is 1, and the weight is wj0 of n, and which is exactly equal to bj of n. And once all these weights are multiplied with the inputs or activations, and once everything is summed up, so we will get vj of n, that is net input or induced local field. Once we got that one, then it will be processed through activation function phi of dot. Once the activation function is applied, it will give you the output yj of n. Once yj of n has obtained, and that will be multiplied with the minus 1, so that bj of n minus yj of n will give us the ej of n, where ej of n is the error at jth neuron. So based on this error, the weights will be updated according to error correction learning rule or delta rule. So those things will be discussed here completely. And this is one of the cases: if the jth neuron is as output neuron, how can we proceed in backpropagation? So next, let us derive the things how it will be. So error signal at jth neuron is ej of n is equal to dj of n minus yj of n, what we have discussed now. So this is, let me take it as a first equation, and the instantaneous error energy for all neurons in output layer is e of n is equal to of sigma j is equal j belongs to c ej of n square. So this is the error energy. So once we need to take the first derivative of it, and we need to equate to zero, so that it will be minimized, and the function will be properly done. That means the error will be zero. So that's what we want. So we will take this one as error energy. So it is E of n is equal to 1 by 2 sigma j belongs to C. I have written wrongly. It's not equal, it's belongs. So Ej of n square. So this is the error energy. So we are going to minimize this energy. So after this, but this is the instantaneous energy. So we need to take if n denotes the total number of patterns in training set. So based on this n, the average squared error energy should be taken, and that will be E average is equal to 1 by capital N sigma n equal to 1 to capital N E of n. So we need to take the average of all these error energy functions. So once this was done, now let us go ahead for cost function. How to define cost function? So E average is the cost function in this case. So now the objective is to adjust the free parameters to minimize the E average. So in this case, according to figure, So from figure we can see that the induced local field we have already discussed, V J of n is equal to sigma I equal to 0 to m W J I of n Y I of n. So it's very clear, it's jth neuron, so the induced local field is V J of n, where n is the nth iteration, and sigma I equal to 0 to m, so there are m nodes, so we need to take like that, and W J I of n is the weight between ith neuron to jth neuron, and Y I of n is the input from ith neuron. So the next thing is, so this is the induced local field. We have already discussed all these things in previous lectures. So this is okay, hence the functional signal. So what will be the functional signal? That is yj of n, which is equal to phi of vj of n, where phi is the activation function. That also we know very well. So this is the cost function. After cost function, we have derived two more things. So once we have done this, let us go to back propagation. So the back propagation depends on the change in weight wji of n. Of course, delta wji of n is proportional to partial derivative of cost function with respect to the weight. That's it. Yes, the weight is only the constraint there, variable there, so we can change the weight. So it should be the partial derivative of energy, error energy, or the cost function with respect to weight. So how to do this? According to chain rule in calculus. So first we need to see one thing. E of n, we know E of n, we know wji. Okay, let me go back and explain you clearly. E of n, so I need to do the partial derivation with E of n. Here, according to second formula, E of n can be partially derivated with respect to Ej only. Yes, E of n is depending on Ej. So I can do partial derivative of E of n with respect to Ej. And coming to first equation, Ej can be partially derivated with respect to Yj of n. Yes, Yj of n is the variable there. And Yj of n. Next, coming to this here, Yj of n can be partially derivated with respect to Wj of n. Okay, but before that, we need to partially derivative here. Yj of n can be partially derivated with respect to Vj of n. And again, Vj of n is partially derivated with respect to Yj of n. Very simple concept. So let me explain you clearly. So this is back propagation. So change in weight is directly proportional to partial derivative of error energy with respect to weight. So according to chain reaction, chain rule in calculus, this is the thing. So there is nothing in it. Our job is to get the partial differentiation of error energy with respect to weight. Okay, but I am unable to do this, but I can do the partial derivation of error energy with respect to E of Ej of n, and I can do the partial differentiation of Ej of n with respect to Yj of n. I can do the same for Yj of n with respect to Vj of n, and I can do the partial differentiation of Vj of n with respect to Wji of n. So I have written like this. So if you cancel dou Ej of n, and if you cancel everything, you will get dou E of n by dou Wji of n. So let us see what are these four partial differentiations, and then we will substitute here. That's it. Very simple. So these are the required derivatives. So differentiating equation 2 on both sides. So equation 2 is the error energy thing. So dou E of n by dou Ej of n, which is equal to Ej of n. So I have named it as 7th equation. And differentiating equation 1 on both sides. So one equation is for error thing. So this is differentiation. So Ej, dou Ej of n by dou Yj of n is equal to minus 1, as Dj of n is a constant, so it will be 0. Next, differentiating fifth equation on both sides. So this is the induced local field. This is not induced local field. This is the functional signal. So once the function has been applied to the induced local field, so this is the thing. The derivative of function will come into picture. So phi dash of vj of n. So now the final thing is differentiating fourth equation on both sides will give us this thing. So differentiating vj of n means induced local field with respect to the weight. So wji of n. So it will be yi of n. So obviously these four equations I can place directly in sixth equation. Substituting 7 to 10 in 6 will give us these things. Dou e of n by dou wji of n is equal to minus ej of n phi dash of vj of n yi of n. Simple concept. No need to worry at all, and everything is derivative only. First we have proceeded with error, and then error energy, and then induced local field, and the functional signal. Only four equations. Based on these four equations we have came all these things. And finally, weight updation. So let's see how the weight will be updated. According to the delta rule, delta wji of n is equal to minus eta dou e of n by dou wji of n. We have already obtained dou e of n by dou wji of n, where we already know eta is the learning rate parameter. So by equation 11 and 12 we can conclude that wji of n is equal to eta delta j of n yi of n. Okay, we have substituted by using 11 and 12 we can write something, but here delta j of n is the extra term. Let us discuss about delta j of n, which is the local gradient, and delta j of n is equal to minus dou e of n by dou vj of n, which is equal to minus dou e of n by dou ej of n, dou ej of n by dou yj of n, and dou yj of n by dou vj of n. Everything is very simple only. Once you practice it, it will easily come into picture. You can easily understand this. Next, dou j of n is equal to ej of n phi dash of. We have simply substitute equation 11 in equation 12. You will get something, and where by this part is called as local gradient, and that is defined like this. And this will be utilized in the next part of the back propagation, and I will explain that. So this is the weight updation. Next, there are two cases here. One case is if jth neuron is an output layer, the jth neuron is in the output layer, then it is supplied with a desired response of its own. So using equation 1 to compute the error signal, and we can use equation 14 for local gradient computation. So it's very easy for us to do it, but it's very difficult if jth neuron is in the hidden layer. If it is the case, the desired response is not at all supplied. So a new approach is adopted, or the extended backpropagation has to be adopted, and that will be explained in the next video to calculate the local gradient. And this is the explanation for backpropagation. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please like it. If you wish to share this video, please share with your friends. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to the YouTube channel, and please press the bell button so that you will get the notification whenever I upload the any video. Thank you so much.